unraveling the mystery that all started with a big bang.
You did the right thing, Colin.
I didn't know what else to do. He's lost all focus. Every day he's got a new obsession. This is a particularly disturbing one.
Mommy?
Hi, baby!
Inside of family, friends, and Almighty God.
Oh, that's too religious.
That lady over there made me say it.
He heard you and he can't unhear you.
Once in a while. Why? So you and Howard can hump on it?
Ladies, I'm sure there's a middle ground.
Shut up, Howard!
Howard, I made cookies for you and your little friends!
They're not my little friends, and we don't want cookies!
Actually, a cookie sounds good.
All right, we'll have cookies! Thank you very much!
It's out of order.
Yes, I can read the sign. I'm just pondering the implications.
I think it implies that the elevator doesn't work.
Again, I can read the sign.
I forgive you.
I didn't ask you to forgive
me. Too bad. I forgive you anyway. And I forgive myself for taking so long to do it. Oh my God, that feels so good.
I must admit it. It does feel good.
What does?
You forgiving me. It means a lot. Thank you.
Hello, Leslie.
Hi, Leonard.
Leslie, I would like to propose an experiment.
Goggles, Leonard.
Right. Leslie, I would like to propose an experiment.
Hang on. I'm trying to see how long it takes a 500 kilowatt oxygen iodine laser to heat up my cup of noodles.
In the past, I would have said something obnoxious like, happy birthday, dumbass. But I'm not gonna do it. You and I have both grown a lot, and it's just so nice to see you all again. So, happy birthday, Sheldon.
Oh, now you know I hate change. Say it.
Happy birthday, dumbass!
Yeah! Hey, Hofstadter. What do on the plasma lab is, you built a robot?
Yes, we did, Kripke.
His name is Monty.
Well, if you have any delusions about entering against my robot, the Kripke Quippler, in the Southern California Robot Fighting League Round Robin Invitational, a.k.a. the SCRFLROI, his name is gonna be Scrap Metal.
Well, this is Sweden calling. Is this Dr. Cooper and Dr. Fowler?
Yes.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
It is my pleasure to inform you that you've won the Nobel Prize in being suckers!
Oh, hey, Leonard. Can I help you find something?
Oh, hey, Stuart. This is Penny. She's just looking for some comic books.
Oh, really? Wow. Blink twice if you're here against your will.
Did you at least save it for the Tooth Fairy?
No, we couldn't find it. We have a theory about where it is, but it'll take 6 to 8 hours to confirm. Speaking of which, where do you keep the spaghetti strainer?
So Penny tells me you're working as a waitress to put yourself through grad school. That's pretty great. What are you studying?
Microbiology.
Oh, cool. So you could study me.
I don't understand.
Microbiology is the study of tiny living things.
I know, I'm studying it.
Yeah, and I said you could study me, because I'm a tiny living thing. It's a joke.
Are you sure?
Hallie, bless her heart, wanted to bring him his boo-boo bear, so she climbed over the safety rail and took a little tumble down the stairs.
She fell down the stairs?
She rolled down the stairs, laughing the whole time. Anyway, when she got to the bottom, there was a tooth missing.
Stuart!
Wait till you see this.
It's fantastic. Unbelievable.
We just can't be this far away from the kids. Bernie's having a meltdown, and frankly, so am I. Well, pull it together. This is a big day for me. Yeah, I wasn't sure what to do. Now I am. We're going home.
Just to be clear, this isn't a date.
Yeah, I know.
And why are you holding my hand?
Excuse me? I'm Amy Farrah Fowler, you're Sheldon Cooper.
Hello, Amy Farrah Fowler. I'm sorry to inform you that you have been taken in by unsupportable mathematics designed to prey on the gullible and the lonely. Additionally, I'm being blackmailed with a hidden dirty sock.
If that was slang, I'm unfamiliar with it. If it was literal, I share your aversion to soiled hosiery.
I would just like to take this moment to say to all the young girls out there who dream about science as a profession, go for it. It is the greatest job in the world. And if anybody tells you you can't,
don't listen. And now, speaking of not listening, my husband, Dr. Sheldon Cooper. Sheldon.
Well, did you finish? Great job.
Agreed. What's your point?
There's no point. I just think it's a good idea for a t-shirt.
How long is it gonna take you to get ready?
I just need like 5 or 10 minutes.
Really?
No, what is wrong with you?
Oh, hi.
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 We don't mean to interrupt. We live across the hall.
Oh, that's nice.
I was there the moment Leonard and Penny met. He said to me that their babies would be smart and beautiful. And now that they're expecting, I have no doubt that that will be the case.
Thanks, Sheldon. I haven't told my parents yet, but thanks.
So if a photon is directed through a plane with 2 slits in it and either slit is observed, it will not go through both slits. If it's unobserved, it will. However, if it's observed after it's left the plane but before it hits its target, it will not have gone through both slits. Howard, Bernadette, Raj, Penny, Leonard. I apologize if I haven't been the friend you deserve. But I want you to know, in my way, I love you all. And I love you. Thank you.